Yo, what's up, guys? How you doing? Welcome to the stream. So the highly anticipated Clone Wars Battle of the Heroes, a Star Wars fan animation, 21 hours ago, 300k views. It's probably like maybe even 400 now. It just hasn't updated yet, most likely. But I've been waiting for this for quite a long time. This like 2 years ago, I think over 2 years ago was the actual trailer for this, and a lot of us were really excited. And now we finally get to, it's 16 minutes long, dude. Like, this is something that we're gonna sit and have some fun with. So welcome to the stream. I hope you're all having a great Saturday. I hope you all had a great Christmas. Hope you will all have a great New Year's tomorrow or New Year's Eve. Be safe. Hey, if we can get some big thumbs up on the screen, let me know what color the thumb turns. Blue, black, white, red. There's different colors that it changes depending on the user, which is pretty cool. I guess it's an engagement way for people to hit like that YouTube created. What's up? How you guys doing? Okay. We're gonna get started here in just a minute. Three and a half years total. That's a long time. Okay. You guys ready? If you're ready, spam one. We can begin. Shout out to everyone that was at the Theory Talks live stream last night till about 6 a.m. It went for 5.5 hours long. Hey, Tyson, what's going on, man? Tyson says you should definitely do a project with this guy sometime. He's definitely the real deal and is up there with your fan film for best I've ever seen. Nice, man. Well, you know what? First of all, I got to finish Vader episode 2 and 3. So we're probably going to have that out by 2024, into 2024, if all goes well. And then I'm also working on my graphic novel, and I'm doing my Theory Saber. So there's a lot I got going on right now. I don't really have time to take on any more projects, but here's just a quick little concept art of one of the new pieces that we're starting for the graphic novel. What's up, Modern Homes? All right, if you guys are ready, make sure to hit that likey and we can begin. Let me just share this on Twitter. One second here. By the way, I linked the original channel in the description if you guys want to check it out. What's up, Darth Renero? He says, hey, Theory, about the Mark Hamill thing. I know it's unfair and ridiculous, but I just wanted to say you matter and you're amazing. Don't ever look back. May the Force be with you. Absolutely, man. Yeah, no. You know, and I don't even think he meant anything by it, hopefully. He just said it on, you know, a post of someone that was trying to cause a lot of... I got a lot to say about it, but also at the end of the day, nah, whatever, man. It is what it is. People are always going to have a problem with me making fan films and projects, but I'm gonna keep making the content that you guys want to see, and that's all I gotta say about that. So here's to 2024 and more. What's up, Modern Homes? I saw William Shatner tweeted me too, though. That's funny. What a day. He's got a good sense of humor. Yeah, did you see what William Shatner tweeted after he said that? He's like, I don't like Star Wars Theory. And then he tweeted something else right after it. So I'll let you guys go see it. Or you can go to my Twitter page. What's up, Matt? The more success you have, the more people envy and hate. Yeah, hey, look, I'm just trying to create cool Star Wars stuff and I speak my mind. But anyways, you guys aren't here for that. Make sure to hit that like button before we begin. Let's try to get 500 likes before we start. We got 1,100 people in the chat here. What up, Zuhair Galaxy? Okay, let's get on this reaction here. All right. Okay, you guys ready? You on? Let me take this off. Take this down here. theory, this video, I swear, will get striked down by Disney. It's that good. Well, we better react to it fast before they do. In 3, 2, 1, let's go. Gotta give it a like right away. All right, 16 minutes of fun. Let's go. Please don't cry. Okay, we'll see. We'll see. Come on, sorry. My green screen's being weird. I gotta fix that. Okay. I think it's good now, right? Okay, now we can begin. What's up, Kevin? Anakin did nothing wrong. If the first three originals didn't exist, Anakin would have won. This is true. It's very true. All right. Hit the thumbs up. Let's begin. Join just in time. Go 4K. Oh, damn. Okay, hopefully... let's let it render out a little bit for a second just so it doesn't, like, pause. 4K. I'll show you that it's... on that 4K action. You're gonna love this. Don't cry in the chat. Hashtag don't cry. Oh, bro. Watch this morning. So I know, dude. I was doing this stream on Theory Talks till about 6 in the morning, and everyone's just like, did you watch it? Did you watch it? And that's not a Star Wars channel, right? Everyone's just talking about it. So obviously, this is probably gonna be a viral video. It's gonna, like, this, their fan film. I watched it literally 30 minutes ago. So awesome. Okay, let's roll. 3, 2. Oh, they took that scene. And they, okay. This is a deleted Clone Wars clip that never got actually finished.
You can't take responsibility for Ahsoka's decision, Anakin.
How would you feel if I turned into a major disappointment?
How'd they do the voice?
It's not the same.
It's precisely the same. You took me under your wing and practically raised me. I'm your Padawan, just like Ahsoka was mine. How well would you sleep knowing I failed you?
Not very well, I imagine. Luckily, that isn't true. And never will be.
I guess that was actually from the clip.
My allegiance is to the Republic, to democracy.
Oh, this is so weird.
If you're not with me, then you're my enemy.
Only a Sith deals in absolutes. I will do what I must.
You will try.
This is so weird. It's like watching it for the first time, but not. What? Holy Oh, they added that in, eh? That's from, yo, That's from Nick Gillard's. That's from Nick Gillard's deleted. Oh, okay. Respect, man. Respect. Damn.
It doesn't have to end like this, Anakin.
The Empire will thrive under my rule, but you won't be alive to see it.
This is so bizarre, man. This is trippy as heck to see, dude. Cause it's like I know this shot for shot, and they're adding like cool scenes that. Scene that they were going to do with the lava, and they were going to manipulate the lava with the force and throw it on each other. It never happened, but I wonder if they're going to do it right now.
I should have known the Jedi were plotting to take over.
Anakin, Chancellor Palpatine is evil.
From my point of view, the Jedi are evil.
Well, then you are lost.
the end for you, my master.
This is so weird.
It's over, Anakin! I have the high ground!
You underestimate my power!
Don't try it! Chosen one! It was said that you would destroy this and not join them! Bring balance to the Force! Not leave it in darkness!
That hits way different animated, and I never thought it would. I think because it's, I think we almost like connect with the animated characters in their own right. Holy shit. That's amazing. These guys did an amazing job with this. Yeah, there's still 6 minutes left. Let's go. These guys did an amazing job. It's kind of like that Toy Story fan film where everything's done shot for shot but with actual toys in stop motion.
I know. I know there's... still...
I never thought it would feel like the first time again. So this is really an interesting feeling. Oh. And they're all clones. I think that's one of the best Star Wars fan films I've ever seen in my, what is it now, 28 years of being a Star Wars fan. That's pretty cool. Like, this was a full-on team, man. They took it from Lego Star Wars 2. Well, who are the voices? Wait a minute. Oh, they're smart. They're smart. Alright. Anyone who... Oh, we can talk about that later. That was honestly, like, really well done. You know, if this doesn't show you that Star Wars really is in the hands of the fans, I don't know what does. It's pretty cool, man. I'm always blown away year after year by the level of fidelity in all of the different Star Wars projects. It's truly amazing. Really well done. Really, really well done. Well done. Insane. Like, I think this should give everyone hope that, hey, you know, maybe Star Wars for some people isn't exactly what they want, but we can take semblance in the fact that fans can create their own crap now, and it doesn't really matter anymore. I'm blown away. That was incredible. The amount of sheer work that took, and money, you know, it was very clever of them to do a Patreon for it. I think that's maybe like a little loophole that I could maybe try and do for Vader, but this video is about them, so make sure you go to their video and hit the like button. It's free, you know, hitting the like button really goes a very far way. It's all content creators want is to hit a like and to make sure you comment, because that pushes the video out. So go to their video, throw a like on it. You know, there was 3,500 people here. So, you know, throwing a like goes a long way for them. Make sure you do that. Make sure you do that on this stream too. It's like this scene in particular right here. When he falls. Was just so cinematic. I think it was right here. Hold on.
You were the chosen one! It was said that you would destroy this sin, not join them! Bring balance to the force! Not leave it in darkness!
Big shout out to Ewan McGregor and Hayden Christensen for obviously paving the way for this performance. And I hope that one day Matt Lanter and James Arnold Taylor will be able to reenact this for fun, but you can hear Anakin say, "Padme, help me." Really? Where? You mean in the scene where the helmet's coming on? Because he says that in the movie, but it's just worded. It's not actually... Let me see. Oh, yeah, you can. Yeah. And he says it in the movie, too. But it's very, 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 very faint. You have to, like, turn up the volume like crazy. That's wild, dude. That's crazy. That's so nuts. Reenacted it in Lego Star Wars? Well, why wouldn't... Nowhere is it said Padme help me. Yes, it is. If you go, Damien, if you go to that scene and you turn up the volume, I literally just heard it right now. So when Vader lost Obi-Wan, his lungs and his throat were completely incinerated. So when he was speaking, it was just like a whisper. And that's why he had the voice changer. Really deep down when he was talking in the suit, he was like, "You have failed me for the last time." It was like that, but it sounded dope. It was just totally different with the voice changer. "You have failed me for the last time." So, it was a tube that went deep down into his trachea. Oh, geez, you guys sent... Okay. Theory, this video, I swear, will get struck down by Disney. It's that good. What's up, Kevin? What's up, Random? He says... Anakin did nothing wrong. The first three originals didn't exist. Anakin would have won. Dude, could I interview for your visual effects in the Vader fan fiction for my project in case studies at second year? Visual effects artist. Let me know. Cheers. Enjoy the video. I really enjoyed it as a Star Wars fan. You could probably interview the visual effects team that I had, or like one of them. I don't know how much help I would be. But if you want to talk about visual effects, the whole thing is CGI for 2 and 3 and the 2 cinematics that I've made. So that's going to be a completely different story. Gifted one, Star Wars 3 members. What's up, Mister? What's up, Ben? 18th month hype. Watch the live version after, bro. Crying. The live version after. Is there a live version? They ran ads on their video? Well, that's up to them, man. Yeah. Would you need 2 years to CGI Heir to the Empire, Dark Force Rising, and Last Command? No. But again, it depends how much money you put into a project. If you put a lot of money into a project right away, it's going to get done as fast as possible. If you're really like kind of waiting and fleshing it out, then... So, you know, with Vader, we had a lot of problems with people that we hired. A lot of them just weren't up to par. And a lot of them wasted tens of thousands of dollars. I'm at a point where I don't really care for the Disney stuff anymore, besides everything with Hayden, because he was my childhood. But I'm really hyped about your stuff. Dave should hire you for real. Man, Dave can create everything that I think of. So, he doesn't need me. You know, I appreciate that, but he can do a great job if he just wants to, if they greenlight it. Easily one of the best animations I've watched, me too. Fantastic job. No wonder it took 3 years. These guys need to finish the Song of Dathomir story. They need to finish the Son of Dathomir. Oh, I think you're saying Son of Dathomir. Oh, yes. Absolutely. I think I can hear the Padme help me a lot more clearly in this than when getting the helmet put on in the actual movie. Yeah, in the actual movie, it's really difficult to discern what he's saying. I'm at a loss for words, says Random D'Lo. A series that can do this to you has to be the best in its genre. I told myself I wasn't going to be salty, but I can't. I'm going to go play the PS2 version and be happy, otherwise I'll pout all day. Got chills when Vader was being raised by the table. Very awesome. Yeah, it was weird watching this because it was like, you just remember what it was actually like watching it for the first time. And I didn't really realize, I sort of had an idea, but I didn't really realize that we were able to actually create a complete separation in the characters between the animated and the live action. You're supposed to conjoin them, but we do totally see them differently. You know, it's kind of like it is Matt Lanter and James Arnold Taylor. You know, it is the difference between the two, between Hayden and Ewan. But at the same time, story-wise, it's the same. So it's really interesting watching it all unfold in cartoon format, too. Because it's like, it's like separated. Clone Wars in live action, while it is so supposed to be the same characters, it is separated, and you do feel that difference. Even the extra fight scenes are so good transitioning into the movie scenes. I wish they showed Palpatine's dialogue. Yeah, they rushed forwards, but I guess for pacing, I suppose. Maybe they were running out of budget. This was so emotional for me, 10 out of 10. I would love to see a Revenge of the Sith remake in the Clone Wars style. Completely. What's up, that works? Hey, Theory. Hope you have a great New Year's and you don't deserve the hate. Appreciate you, man. Hey, thank you, bro. Appreciate it. Hate is just free marketing. How would you rank this with other fan films? It's definitely up there. Probably top five. I mean, you got to put Ryan vs. Dorkman as the OG. You got to put... what was that one? I watched it in the 90s, I think it was. It was, it was like a spoof on Tatooine of Stormtroopers. It was like a spoof on Cops. I think it was called Troops or something. Troopers or something like that. There's that. I like the OG stuff. And then there's the Darth Maul fan film. What else we got? There's a few others. I can't put mine in there because that's biased. When Anakin says power in the "you underestimate my power" line, his eyes go from blue to Sith yellow. Crazy attention to detail. Are you still making the Luke deepfake series? Yeah. Yeah, I just got an update on it today. Absolutely, man. We're doing a great job. The difference between this and Clone Wars and Rebels was the music. The other series have bland music. I think Clone Wars has really good music. Especially Season 7. What's up, Jose? How you doing, man? Hopefully Star Wars content gets better or released by Disney. Right, but it doesn't really matter. It doesn't matter because we have fan films like this. You know, if we got guys creating stuff like this, it may take 3 years. But honestly, if we start funding fan films, like all you have to do is just go to their Patreon, send the money. And they will get this stuff done. It's the same with my stuff. Just super chat, watch videos, comment, like, join the channel and the memberships, buy the merch. You support the content you want, right? It's the same thing as like Disney. You support them by buying their merch, by buying their memorabilia, by watching their movies, by subscribing to Disney Plus. Which is the same as a YouTube membership. Much more expensive. So it's the exact same model. It's just you're supporting a massive company, corporation, versus a single entity, right? A single person, a fan. Clone Wars, at least the last couple seasons, seem to hit harder than any other Star Wars. Yeah, I agree with that. What's up, Jose? Do you think we'll ever find the Clone Wars stories we missed out on get finished now that Dave is up there? I mean, I hope so. What else are they going to make? you know, more offshoot shows like Skeleton Crew or something? No, I mean, they got so much source material. Opposite of what Kathy says, they got so much stuff that they can create that they haven't touched yet. You know how many comics and books that they can go and make a simple Clone Wars animation of? Or, you know, even 2D Clone Wars animation, even 2D animation, right? It's super simple. They can create, you know, Tales of the Jedi. Like, just keep pumping that out every 6 months. Man, they're Lucasfilm. They got all the money in the world. They could create that literally every 6 months if they so wish. If they really wanted to put that much money into it, they could do it. They have all the assets now. Imagine combining this with the last Clone Wars episode and the Tales of the Jedi part when you see Padme. Yeah. Did you notice that we hear hints of our boys, Ewan and Hayden, from time to time? Yeah. Yeah. A lot of the grunts, screams. I'd rather see series based on some of the Star Wars Visions episodes than them ruin more main content. Yeah, Genndy Tartakovsky animations for the win. If you guys haven't seen the 2D Clone Wars, I really, really encourage you to go watch it. It's on Disney Plus. You can check it out. I want Revenge of the Sith Clone Wars and some of the Clone Wars arcs done in live action. Everyone deserves to shine. Yep. For the record, I'm so excited for your Luke series. I know you can't run ads on it, but we will help fund it, bro. Just tell us how. Thank you, man. Yeah, super chats really help buying the sabers. I'm releasing a saber as soon as I can, probably in January. That will be around the $300 to $400 range, and it'll be able to do everything you want. It'll have smooth swing. I'm not going to make much money on it, but you guys really wanted something cheaper for the masses, and like, you know, $300 to $400, I can make that happen. It's kind of like exchanging money at that point, but that's something you guys want. So, you know, I want everyone to have a saber if they want to, and I want it to be from my brand. So, or, you know, my company at least, because everything that goes in will come out in fan films and projects and stuff that I'm doing. So yeah, you know, it's very simple. You support the creators as easy as if you don't have money, you just hit like. Literally hit like on the video. It's as simple as going, boop. That's all YouTube wants. You hit like, and it will make the video go viral. I want Revenge of the Sith and Clone Wars and some of the Clone Wars arcs done in live action. Yeah. If you want some goosebumps, cue up the one last time trailer for the 90s OT VHS release. Oof. Yeah. I have all those, man. What's up, Bronzy Beast? Thanks for the super chat, dude. Thank you for supporting the channel and the content. Hello, I'm a fan film student in Sweden and will graduate in June. I was just wondering, like, would it be possible at all to be part of the team on one of the Vader fan film? Happy New Year. Absolutely, yeah. I mean, if your skills are up to par, for sure. Yeah. But, you know, what are your skills? Are you good at the effects? Are you good at compositing? Are you good at rigging? Are you good at environments? You know, we have some of the best in the world working on Vader Episode 2. And I mean that. The team we have working on it, and this is why we have so many new people coming and then leaving within just a few weeks, is because they're all busy working on major motion pictures in the world. Know all the biggest movies, whether it be Marvel, Star Wars, whatever, DC, you know, the shows, Last of Us, all, you know, I literally have the world's best working on Vader Episode 2. It's not going to be a little fan film. You guys will see. Can you do more fitness stuff? You inspire me so much. Sure, yeah, of course. Thanks, Edwin. Sound effects supervisor here, Chiseled Knickknack, the lead sound designer, is here too. Oh, from the fan film, this fan film? Thank you for all your kind works and love from fans. Michael Pierlucci, are you in this? Oh my gosh, hey, what's up, man? Dude, thank you so much for your work. Chat, we have the celeb here himself. Sound effects supervisor. If you guys want to find him on Instagram, Chiseled Knickknack. I'm going to follow you right now. That's so cool. Chiseled. Nick. Knack. Not popping. Oh, there we go. Got you. No, that's not it. I think it did it wrong. Chiseled? I can't seem to find you. Can you please watch best Anakin tribute video called Anakin Skywalker Darth Vader by Gamersticks? It's phenomenal. All the feels. Sure, we can watch that in a little bit. I'm going to stream for a bit, so I'm going to hang out with you guys. Can you say roughly how long Vader Episode 2 will be? About half an hour. And Vader Episode 3 will be also half an hour. Vader 3 is where I'm really excited. Like, I'm excited for 2, but 3, Yeah. It would be cool to see the duel between General Grievous and Obi-Wan in Clone Wars style. It would be. Hey, Michael, can you guys create more stuff like this? It's pretty much an empty IG, unfortunately. Don't really use it much. Fair enough. Okay. Figured that would be a good way for us to be in touch. You guys did an amazing job. Really should be proud. Congratulations. Really, really good job. Crazy. Any spoilers for Vader Episode 2? No. I don't really want to give you guys any spoilers. Will Episode 2 be longer than the first? Yeah, Episode 2 is going to be about 3 times as long. So the first one was about 12 minutes. This next one will be like anywhere between at least 25 to like 30 something, 30 plus. Oh, thank you, Michael. Tyler Groh is the composer. Awesome. He's a talented guy. What about the fights from the 2D series in this animation? The Windu versus Grievous fight? Yeah. I mean, hey, Michael, is there going to be any sort of chance that you guys will be making more stuff like this? Would you consider doing a screening in Irvine, California for Vader 2? Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to be doing a screening for Vader 2, but it just depends. Once I'm happy with the finished product, then yeah, for sure. Anticipated release date for Vader 2? Hopefully end of 2024 is what we're aiming. Yo, hello there themselves. Yo, thanks for the support. Glad you like it. We had a blast making it. Yeah, you did an amazing job. Chat, if you want to check them out, I linked their description first thing. I linked their channel first thing in the description. Make sure you go over there, show support. Always show support to your favorite YouTubers by hitting the like button. And I'm sure they have like a Patreon or something. Are they going to continue another one? Are you guys going to make another one? That'd be cool. Yeah, I want to see more. That was great. It was awesome. What's up, Will? Thanks, Will. W in the chat for hello there. Yeah, everyone riddled the chat with emojis and W's for hello there. They did a fantastic job on this fan film. This is exactly what the fandom needs. We need more stuff like this. Fans take the initiative to just make cool shit. Can't imagine how much this must have cost and how much time it took, man. I could tell when Anakin's reaching for the sand, I was like, yeah, there's no way they're gonna make those individually move. Wait, you make them individually move? Hold on, why didn't that show up the first time I watched? Are you kidding? Oh my god, dude, I must have like looked away or something at that moment. That's crazy. I bet that would have been, that must have been tough. So cool. I love that shot. I think that's my favorite shot. I'd make that the thumbnail, man. That's wild. I'd love to see Duel of the Fates made in animation style. Yeah. You should get Hello There on one of your shows on Monday. Absolutely. Anytime they want. Would love to have them on. As the sound team, we never asked to be paid. We did it because we wanted to. Okay, well, that's amazing. That's amazing. Can you guys work for me? I'm paying all my guys. You know, it's that's amazing. You know, it's a labor of love. And on the first episode, we had a lot of people that were fans. And a lot of them did it for free as well. On this second one, I feel like, to speed up the process and to get people that I, you know, I really want it done a certain way. It's been an interesting process, definitely finding the right crew. And I'm glad that you guys found that. It's amazing. It, to me, I think when making fan films, that's the most difficult part of it is literally finding the right team of people. You know, everyone wants to put their name on a Star Wars project, especially if it's going to get a lot of notoriety, but it's about finding the right people who are passionate and really care about it and aren't in it for the money or the fame or the name or to put their name on the credits. It's about people that really just have a love for Star Wars and kind of tap into that young version of themselves. And it's just something that they want to do, right? It's amazing. Very small group of people. You guys did a fantastic job. No plans for more recreations at the moment, but I am interested in original animated Star Wars content. We'll see. I'll be uploading the project files for fans to use. Oh my god, that's amazing. That's amazing. Wow. What's up, King Wools? Your drive and work ethic really inspires me. Just know that you're one of the people I look for. I look to for motivation when it comes to content creation. Well, that's a very endearing comment and very generous super chat. Thank you, King Wolves. I really don't think I'm anyone special, man. I just think I have a vision and I want to see it through. And that's it, you know? And you just work towards it until you get it. That was dope. Need a fan-made What If? W for Star Wars. Could you imagine if all the fan fictions were just like made in this style? That'd be so cool. Vader model looks so much better than the actual Clone Wars. Well, it's the fact that they got the animation down so well and the lighting and the lightsabers. Yo, Matt Boardman. Yo, everyone shout out Matt Boardman. He is one of the talented artists working on Vader Episode 2 currently as we speak. Bravo sound team. When you have that passion, you don't mind doing things for free. The reward is the end result. Vader 2 for the win. Yeah, Matt's actually one of the other guys that's like, we've been working for free, and Matt, you're going to have to get paid eventually, man. You're going to have to get something, but I appreciate you. He does an amazing job. If I were Disney, I would be biting my nails from this fan film. You see the Cad Bane fan film? Yeah, well, that one was live action, right? Who did the voice acting for the animation? Yeah, guys, who did the voice acting? I mean, besides the parts that were from the film. Are you going to combine all three fan films when you finished? Yeah, of course. It's going to be over an hour long. Yo, thank you, Get Me Greek. Love you too. Being able to let people just feel like kids again. Ah, love. Yes. Most of these lines are for Lego Star Wars. Oh, I see. I don't think it's AI generated voice. It just was too good. So Clone Wars makes sense. Like Lego Clone Wars makes sense to me. 1344, you can see Anakin's eyes through the helmet. Pause it when the table rises. You can see Anakin's red eyes in the lenses. Oh, yeah, right. You can. That's pretty cool. Let's see if I can... That's pretty neat. Editing and camera work. Mainly looking for lower roles because lack of real-world experience. How could I send you some of the projects from school? Oh, I'm sorry, man. If it's lower roles, then yeah, there's no space for that right now. So we're pretty chock full of our team. But, you know, if you have a ton of experience, then yeah, we would definitely be looking for that. But as for camera work, there is no camera work since it's going to be all CGI. So it's kind of easy in that sense. Yo, Chad! Oh my god, how was my sleep? It was garbage. Chad was during at the Theory Talk stream last night. We had a 5.5 hour stream till 6 something in the morning. It was a fun time. But man, I'm tired. I woke up with the biggest headache.
It was funny though. I was so delirious, so tired.
That's a dangerous time to stream because you guys can just like say anything. I'll answer anything. It's just, it's not a good time. Or maybe it is a good time. If Lucasfilm takes this down like they did with your film, they're obviously jealous. Well, Lucasfilm never took my film down. Right? Nobody ever took my film down. They just ran ads on it when the agreement was that no one would be making money from it. And you know, that was a big deal for me to spend $160,000 on a project that would make no money, right? So when I advertised it a million times to fans saying that there would be no ads running, and then there were ads running, a lot of fans were like, you know, you're only out for the money, you lied to us, you put ads on it. So I'm like, whoa, I gotta address this, man, because this doesn't look good. Like, look, this wasn't me, this was Disney that did that. So and then of course it, people then saw it for what it was and they were like, wow. And they came to the aid of the fandom. So well, yeah. But yeah, Lucasfilm I think was the one that actually, from what I heard, came in to step in, and they were like, hey, you know, you got to remove that claim because we had an agreement with this kid. So. Do you prefer this over live action? I mean, no. Live action forever. But this is honestly amazing. You know, we need this too because we have such a connection with the other cartoon characters. Somebody better notify the Disney Crybaby legal police on Twitter. This animation is copyright infringement, says Knights of Melvin. Yes, absolutely. But it's not from me, so it's okay. All hail the Knights of Melvin. Give yourself to the dark side. Gifted 1 Star Wars Theory membership. Thank you, Unfunny German. Why are you not funny? Yeah, who do I email about the whole claim thing? Because I would really enjoy it if there weren't ads running on this. Well, did you use copyrighted music? So I didn't email anybody. I had a contact at Lucasfilm and I was like, I'm not even gonna mention it. All I did was make a video and you guys took care of me. You guys like executed Order 66. That was insane. I did not expect that. I just wanted to be like, yo, look, it's not me. I'm not making money off this. How was the animation? Gonna watch it after. It was actually amazing, dude. Yeah, it was very well done. Hello, my brethren. Hello, Satoshi. Yo, King Wools! Gifted 5 Star Wars Theory memberships. You guys better grab them fast. They're free. Oh, Phil TMNT took it. Paper Storms. Melvin took it! Melvin is now a member. What's up, L Sparky? Hope you guys enjoy the 15% off on the merch. For members only. There are only 6 Star Wars films. Some would argue so, yes. I believe. Yuri's my best friend, right on. You know what I can't wait for is the Mando watch parties. I mean, unless they make it into a movie, but dude, I see, like, besides season 3, I really miss the Mando watch parties with you guys. Those were the best time. I'm getting skeptical about Acolyte. I don't know what to think. I'm worried about it, but I hope it's going to be good. Are you excited for Happy New Year's? Yeah, I'll be streaming with you guys, man. Today I'm going to be streaming with you. And then I'm going to eat food and go to the gym. And then just come home, probably game. How do gifted memberships work? You got to be fast enough to grab them. Yo, Sama Ramen. Ramen is a 12-month... Dude, you hit a year. Congratulations. Thank you. This music gets me hyped up, yeah. Absolutely. Season 3 doesn't count. It's not canon. You got that right. What's up, Rossi? You grab them. Like, if someone throws, like, buys 5 3 ones, it'll pop up in the chat and you just claim. Claim it, claim it, claim it, claim it. I miss having a new Star Wars show to discuss in a civilized manner. Yeah, I miss being viralized on Twitter. Headland will destroy the lore. Oh, we'll see, dude. I think fans will be quite outspoken if she does anything like that. I hope not. For your sake, Admiral. Much love, Master Theory, but we must know, is there no ignorance, only knowledge? Or is peace a lie, and there is only passion? By your choice, we shall judge ye. Yes, my master. Lost to have revenge. Lost to reveal ourselves to the Jedi.
The time has come, my apprentice. The fan films are in full effect. I told you to come to this. The fans are taking over. Help me, Anakin. Disney will fall.
Well, I sound like Gandalf.
Great fan films, you fools. You shall not copyright!
It was fantastic. We need a Jedi Purge Vader series, yeah. Can you rewatch it? You want me to rewatch it? Yo, spam one if you want me to rewatch it. I'll do it. Hit the like button if you want me to rewatch it. I'll do it, sure. Some of you just rolling in here now. Oh, Spooky Sapper, what's up, man? I see you. With that Admiral Attitude emoji next to you, next to your name, means you're a longtime member, my friend. Hey, so if you guys don't have any plans tomorrow for New Year's Eve, you're not going out. I don't drink, I don't do drugs, I don't party, I don't go out. Sometimes I'll go out to, like, here or there, but I don't drink or do drugs. But if you guys are staying in, you got nothing to do, I'm going to be streaming a lot tomorrow. We'll be doing Lego. I might go pick up a new Lego piece today or something, or build one of the ones that I have sitting, and keep you guys company. We're just going to hang out and have a good New Year's Eve together. Sound good? We're streaming all day. All night. Alright, I guess we're rewatching it. Okay, hit that thumbs up button. Let's get on this party. Let's do it. Oh my god. Check out Bosk Scorekeeper, Revan and Rescue Mission fan films. The effects in Bosk are really good, and the Revan fan films have decent fights and choreography. Okay, we can check it out after. Crucial scene to recreate. Prequel and Clone Wars Anakin always felt different, but having Clone Wars Anakin fulfill his character arc finally intersected them for me. Yeah, they did a fantastic job with that. Get the Razor Crest Lego set. Which is that? Oh, it was like $200. Yeah. I say we like level up our Lego stuff. Like we start building good stuff. Maybe I'll get like a bigger table. I get like, you know, a camera that's pointing down at my hand. I think we do that. And then, you know, we go up from there. Okay, let's watch this. Right on, Damien. I see your comment. I built the Venator a long time ago. There's a video on the channel of me building it. Go check it out. Well, it's not the Venator, it's just Super Star Destroyer.
Can't take responsibility for Ahsoka's decision, Anakin.
How would you feel if I turned into a major disappointment?
It's not the same.
I'd love to see animated series of Obi training Anakin, Vader hunting Jedi, episode 3 of Luke between 5 and 6.
I'm your Padawan, just like Ahsoka was mine. How well would you sleep knowing I failed you?
Not very well, I imagine. Luckily, that isn't true.
Hey, Mr. Theory, you're the coolest guy. Thanks, Nathan. Thanks for supporting the channel, man. Yo, Rossi, I'll read that in 15. Cool, bro?
Anakin, my allegiance is to the Republic, to democracy!
Thank you, man.
If you're not with me, then you're my enemy!
Only a Sith deals in absolutes. I will do what I must.
You will try.
Mm-hmm.
doesn't have to end like this, Anakin.
The Empire will thrive under my rule, but you won't be alive to see it.
I almost felt like if Obi-Wan did a little more trying to convince Anakin in that moment, then maybe something would have come out of it, you know? Was always so dope in the movie when they get in this part. Yeah, that part. So sick. Oh, they even got the foot positions right. Cool, because like in that moment they switch to Yoda and Palpatine. So it's nice that it's just like continuous.
Take over.
Like this moment.
Anakin, Chancellor Palpatine is evil.
From my point of view, the Jedi are evil.
Well, then you are lost.
Like, instead of Obi-Wan just being like, you are lost at that moment, why couldn't he just been like explaining a little bit more to me? Like how do you not see that he was trying to kill Padme this entire time and now he's using you? Like, that would have just like, he's supposed to be called the negotiator. I just feel like in that moment he could have tried and negotiated a little bit better, but I guess he was done. I guess he was like, ah, screw you, Anakin. You're far gone, dude.
This is the end for you, my master.
It's over, Anakin. I have the high ground.
You underestimate my power.
Don't try it. One. It was said that you would destroy this and not join them. Bring balance to the Force. Not leave it in darkness.
Sound team did such a good job. Like, points to different characters, you can hear it in like one headphone. Like, it's far away.
I hate you!
Must have been bad for Palpatine too. Imagine like brainwashing this kid for 13 years. And he just ends up messing it all up. He's literally like the key to Palpatine's empire. And he destroys everything. But yet, you know, it still works for a bit. And it would have if Vader didn't cave to Anakin's emotions with Luke. Listen. Yeah, you can hear it. Padme, help me. Right there. They even got the smoke moving, too. That's crazy. Really good job.
Obi-Wan. There's quite a name. I know. I know there's... Still...
So well done. So well done. Padme was actually my wife, not Anakin's. Yeah, I like when we were kids, she was all of our wives. Yes. Well. Such a good job. Yeah, I mean, Star Wars is in the hands of the fans, bro. Like, it just doesn't, we don't even need the real thing anymore. If it ain't George doing it, man. With his eyes open on the table, it's just a nice shot. So good. We watched you during the Arnold on Stargrift. We watched you watching Arnold on Stargrift on Arnold's stream yesterday. It was fun. He said this show with you was one of his highlights of the year. I love that guy. I guess you're all right as well. Yeah, I love that guy too. I like him a lot. In the scene in Revenge of the Sith when Padme is crying looking out at the temple burning, is she crying because she's scared for Anakin's life, or is it because deep down she knows he's behind it? She's scared for Anakin's life, dude. Always been a big fan of your What If videos. You did What If Anakin left the temple with Ahsoka but never did the part two. Need that, dude. We do need that. We need a lot of part twos that I gotta finish. Theory, love the channel. Would love it if you did a tier list on the books sometime. Yeah, that could be fun. I haven't read all the books though. So, you know, I can kind of only do it on the ones that I've read. This gave me chills. It's so good. 9 out of 10. I'm glad you liked it, Chad. Glad you liked it. Glad I could watch it with you, dude. Yeah, remember to go on their video, throw them a subscribe, throw them a follow, throw them a like. I linked it in the description, and throw a like on this video too while you're here. We're almost at 2,000 likes. Keep hitting that like button. Let's try to get there. The sounds for the robots is almost all Foley, and how he did the sounds is genius. Voice modulation and washer machine parts. Really? Wow. Washer machine parts? For what? For Foley, he did that? For, like, washer machine parts? That's crazy.
But where's Padme? Is she safe? Is she all right?
The sneak peek you'll get for Vader 2 would be end of January, most likely. I have a theory Palpatine knew that Vader would get burned. He wanted that to complete his fall to the dark side. No. He didn't want that. Hell no, not at all. Dude, he was disappointed. He was mad. 500 SFX. That's crazy. 500 sound effects clips. I think a good thing to add in Vader Episode 2 would be Mace using purple force lightning on Vader. It would make sense because Mace would use his Shatterpoint ability. No. You can't have Mace using dark side powers. You can't do it.
You'd lose so many fans. You'd be like, what?
It's just, like, it's cool, but it's, you know, you gotta be true to the characters. Right? That's the really difficult part with Star Wars is you have to know the characters so well that you can't mess it up. That's why a lot of these writers that come in there, I think they have an idea, right? But the reason it just doesn't feel real is because they don't know these characters well. And the only way to know them is not just by studying them. It's by really feeling them, growing up with them over decades of time. I got my name in the credits for the Patreon supporters, and we were all in the Discord patiently waiting. It's still crazy that it's finally here. You know, it took a long time, and thank you for supporting that project. You should watch Tested interview with Ben Burtt. It's true to the lore, though. If Mace used purple lightning? No. He can't do that. Can't do that. I mean, it would be cool if he, like, maybe, like, sent, like, a few sparks or something, but... No. It would be too weird for his character. Dan the Man, it's probably because you have a private profile, I guess. How long could Anakin last if his suit got damaged in combat, like his respirator and such? Well, he would use the Force. He did that a lot in the comics. He would use the Force to sustain his life. But you can only do it for so long. We got like the whole crew, cast and crew of this fan film in here. Tyler Gross says, we got my score producer, Luke Truan Music. The music was elevated by Luke's contributions and notes. Additionally, he mixed the music. Right on. Congratulations, man. You did a great job. Yeah, no, Mace is not balanced, but, like, you can't do that. You can't have... He's going to be a little more grizzled and dark anyways, but I can't be having him use Force Lightning. That would be so weird. In the shot before the mask goes down, they even had the bottoms of the mask on, unlike the actual movie. Also, I'm a big fan. Keep up the good work. Thank you, Jeremy. Yeah, they didn't miss a beat. Yo, Rossi, thank you for being you. The journey to get Arnold T on was maybe the best part of the year for me. I never thought it would work, and it brought me closer to the Star Wars community. I hope 2024 is groundbreaking for you. Cheers. Thanks, Rossi. Yeah, I believe it will be too. I think we'll get a lot of big things done, for sure. And for those of you who enjoy my fan fictions, make sure to check out my other channel called Theories Tales. Working on my graphic novel right now for it, but essentially there I do the same thing I do on my Star Wars channel, where I create custom stories, and I voice them, and I narrate them, and I send them to my sound engineer, who worked on Vader Episode 1 and 2 and 3. And he does all of the sound manipulation, music, sound effects, and brings it to life. And right now we're working on the conclusion to the story. So that'll be out probably tomorrow or the next day. Force lightning is not a normal Sith skill either. Yeah, Mace ain't using lightning. Okay. Do you think Mace would have eventually turned to the dark side if he successfully landed the last strike on Palpatine? No. No, he has immense control. Do you think they'll go through with the Rey movie? Yeah. What channel is that? It's called Theories Tales. It's already over 10,000 subscribers, growing strong just in a few weeks. The outpouring fandom on there is actually getting quite massive. Very fast. Yo, thank you, Darth Revan, for joining. Hope you have a great day. No reason why we can't have a good Star Wars show. Yeah. Grievous versus Obi-Wan and Utapau in Clone Wars style. Rey movie will be a big flop? Yeah, probably, dude.
Who besides Plo Koon uses lightning amongst the Jedi Masters anyway? None. He was the only one. What's some content you guys want to see in the new year? I got a lot planned for you, but I'm just wondering what you guys want to see particularly. What's up, JM? What'd I think of the animation? Amazing. Beautiful. What's up, Gaming Thief? What's up, boys? What's up, Lucas? Rogue 2 Revenge of the Rebels? I want Vader Episode 2 so bad. Patience, young one. Some more streaming of our new Movie Duels content would be cool. Definitely, we can do that. More deep dive into comics, more reactions to fan films, more live streams. I'm enjoying Theories Tales. Telling stories is what I do and why I started my channel. So great to see your stuff. Always enjoy others' creations. Thank you. How do you think a scene would play out between Plagueis and young Anakin and the Phantom Menace? Well, Plagueis was actually headed to see young Anakin and the Phantom Menace. And I made a video on that. It's actually pretty dope. Thanks, Lance Guy. When's Jeremiah returning to play Red Dead Redemption 2? I think we'd all love to see your finish that game, and if you haven't already. Yeah, I'm still gonna finish GTA the campaign. I think we're on part 9 now. Spam one if you're sub to my gaming channel. We do a lot of live streams there with campaign games and some multiplayer games and stuff. What if more MCU again? You'll love that, I guess. What's up, Taylor? You think Yoda lost to Palpatine, or was it just bad positioning after the Force explosion? It was bad positioning, man. But, you know, he did say in the book that he lost, so... Working dudes on tube, keep it up. You're doing great things across the board. Thanks, that works. Appreciate it, man. the live stream for Fallen Order will be unforgettable. That was a good one. That was a good time.
Yeah, exactly. Yoda even says it. Feels I have.
Some EU content would be awesome. I still make that, yeah. Vader got injected with some Tren on the operating table. Tales of the Jedi cycles covered. Anakin lost his anti-estrogen. What the heck? Episode 2 to 3. You guys are funny. You should make a horror film short of General Grievous in the catacombs. Ooh, that'd be wild. Yeah, that'd be rough. We need Star Wars jazz music made? Yeah. I got you. It's great, isn't it? Good little vibe. Of course I watched it. What's up, Steve? Let's see what it did there. What show would you love to see? Young Palpatine, but I don't know why they're not making it. You should be working for Star Wars with the talent and love you have for the franchise. Ah, I work for you guys. Remember when Yoda said, failed, no nut. Damn it, Chad. Thanks again for the last night's stream. Child Anakin 1000 milligram test per deci.
His test is off the charts, Master. Master Yoda doesn't even have trend that high.
What are your thoughts on a potential Vader series? I mean, I'm trying to make one. Yeah. Definitely. I'd love an official one.
Crazy. They're still making Percy Jackson movies?
It was like 20 years ago. Heir to the Empire animated trailer. What's what I'm trying to do right now with AI stuff and like Unreal Engine. Last night's stream was cool, bro. I wanted to hop off like 66 times. Yeah, me too. Chalamet would end up paying Young Palps. Ah, what about that? Will you build some of the 40th anniversary Return of the Jedi series? I'd love to. The sets, yeah. Be cool. Oh, the Percy Jackson thing is a show? Is it with the same actor or is it all new people? You heard of the Star Wars lo-fi mix on Closed on Sunday? Can you guys hear my husky howling right now? To the ambulance?
What's up, Jose? Rain!
It's a definitely much better time to stream. What's up, Frank Dukes? You hear it a bit? Thank you for your comment on my video. Theory means a lot. I had a dream 3 weeks ago that you commented on the exact video, so now that you actually did, I kind of had to do a double take. So weird.
Oh. Maybe you're clairvoyant. Maybe you can sense the future, young Jedi.
Star Trek connections to Star Wars. There are some. Of course. Palpatine was a redhead?
Yeah.
I guess so.
New people, it's faithful to the novels? Okay, cool. I think I read one of the, or a part of the novels when I was a kid.
Yeah, the actors were adults in the original one. I was like, how does this work?
Vader episode 1 in CGI? Yeah, we could do that once we finish 2 and 3. I love late nights being on the computer and having theory talks in the background. Right on. Yeah, Galactic Empire. Yeah. No, I've messaged them a few times. They've messaged me too. That's cool. Yeah, they're cool.
I haven't finished the Lego build yet. Oh, it's still over there in the corner. What about the droid attack on the Wookiees?
What about them? What is this music in the background? It's on my channel if you guys want to watch it or listen to it on repeat. It's called Darth Vader's Lo-Fi Beats to Relax, Study, Listen to. Star Wars Lo-Fi Chill Mix. And, yeah, it's made by Samuel Kim. It's a really, really nice mix. Vader was on a cruise and couldn't wait to blast, so he blasted all around. Oh my god, dude. Yeah, he was on a cruise of Trent. A 300-page Star Wars book. Wow. Haven't returned it to the library in 6 years. You ever seen that Even Stevens episode where the guy that's from the library like comes looking for them, looking for beans? We know about the long journey home. And then Lewis and Twitty think that he's an alien. That was a good episode. Man, I watched Even Stevens so much as a kid. It's crazy.
Oh, I got a lot of plans for 2024, man.
Y'all will see.
Yeah, a lot of plans. A lot of work. A lot of work to be done.
Ain't gonna be done by itself. Even Stevens is a name I haven't heard in a long time.
Yeah. It's great.
Beans was nasty. Beans was the best part of the show. But not Aaron Guerin, baby.
And Even Stevens was a good front. Yes. Oh.
Carrie Fisher was in Even Stevens?
Oh, yeah, I think she was. Can't remember.
Jedi. What's up, bro? What's up, Angel?
Angel.
Angel Arellano. Watch Obi in Clone Wars PTSD. I've seen that one.
Seen that one, mate. Yeah.
Let's play some video games. Good. I'm really hungry. I'm gonna go eat something.
We cover some stuff from the original trilogy archives by Paul Duncan.
Yeah, you know, I've been really focusing on the prequel trilogy for the last few years that I haven't really done much on the OT book.
Oh, Drop Dead Fred.
Knights of the Fallen Empire. Palpatine would clap every old Republic Sith. I think Palpatine would clap almost everybody, man. I'm kind of like getting to that conclusion. Order a pizza? Yeah, I'd be down. Why not?
What's up, Quinn Brewer? Will you do a watch party for the movie Fanboys 2009? Of course I've watched it. I've watched that when it came out. That was a staple. That was awesome. I can't believe they got William Shatner in it. Order a feast for New Year? Well, we'll stream all day tomorrow, probably.
You've prepared a feast, Jones.
What are your thoughts on calories in, calories out? It's so much more than that. Yeah, I should start doing videos on my workout channel. Strength theory. Probably start, man. But yeah, yo, I'm gonna go eat some food, and then I'm gonna go to the gym, and then maybe we'll do a stream later tonight, but I'll be on Theory Talks later, most likely tonight. Probably around 11, or maybe even midnight Pacific time, so I'll see you guys there. And then, of course, all tomorrow, we're gonna be streaming all day, and we're gonna be doing Lego builds, we're gonna be doing fan film reactions, and just hanging out and having fun, so. Hey, Theory, can I share some of my theories? Of course you can. I'm in the gym right now training lats and traps. That's an interesting combination, but fun. All day, you say? Eh, you know, sort of. Kind of. Kind of. Alrighty, guys. Had a great time. Hope you enjoy your evening. And see you later tonight for some more streams. I love you all. May the force be with you. Leave a like on this video before you leave. And enjoy your evening. Later. Thank you.